All right, everybody, it's the last week of quarter one, so kind of crunch time. I know a lot of you have done an awesome job through a really difficult situation as we're all adjusting to, you know, the new normal and remote learning, and virtual everything. Some of you haven't checked in quite enough, and you are behind on some things. But no matter what situation you're in, I've got some really important information for you here, some reminders, and one thing that's a change of plans that if you're in good shape, well, you want to hear this stuff so you stay in good shape and keep your grade up. If you're not in too good a shape or your grade's a little lower than you want it to be, here's your last chance before the end of quarter one to get it boosted up and get yourself credit or a higher grade. So important stuff here. I also am including this Google Slides presentation, just the link to it. So you can definitely go look that stuff over after you watch my video. Then you can look at it at your own leisure without me yapping at you. All right, here we go. So last call for missing assignments. I know every teacher has a slightly different policy on that. I've been pretty clear throughout the marking period that I do take missing work. I'd rather get it late than never. And I wanna encourage you to get work done. And I also know this was just a weird time. It was unlike any start to the school year that I've ever experienced. And I know it's you guys are adjusting and most of you have done a nice job with that. But if you ever did get behind on some stuff or weren't able to check in, here's the thing, if you have like a medical excuse and you sent that in to me, I would give it to you like full credit for it. If you just missed the due date, I still would rather have it from you. You will take a point deduction for it, but it's always way better than a zero. This would include any of the like assignments, daily assignments, or really I don't do them every day, but once a week or so, any of those weekly kind of writing assignments, quizzes, projects, like the art projects, the Ford Motor Company one. So if you're missing any of that stuff, submit it to me. Very important thing though, make sure you send me an email. If you just go submit it on an assignment thread from a month ago, I mean, think of it. I post a new lesson every day and a lot of them have assignments attached to them. If I had to go back for all of my classes, all 120 students and check those all the time, I would go crazy. So I'm happy to take the late work. I want to get you your points for it. But if you submit anything ever past the due date, especially this week, you need to send me an email on the side and tell me what assignment you submitted. Then I know where to go check and I'll do the best I can this week because probably quite a bit of stuff will be coming in, but I'll do my best to get your points in there well before my grades are due and report cards get printed. I also highly recommend that you go check PowerSchool. Just look your grade over. You should really be doing that all the time anyway, like every once a week, maybe once every other week. But now is an especially crucial time. You really should do it for all your classes. Just double check that all the stuff that you've done, you do have scores in there for it. Make sure that I didn't have an oversight or miss something that you should get credit for. If you notice anything that doesn't look right, you don't even have to be 100% ironclad on it that you know, like I missed something. Even if you think you turned it in, but you're not totally sure, well, you can go back and check on your own, or you could just shoot me an email and I'm happy to look into it for you. You know, we're all humans, teachers too. So we make mistakes and I've got a lot of assignments to grade and a lot of students. So it's possible I did overlook something somewhere. So by all means, communicate with me and I'll try to do my best, the best I can to get back with you ASAP. And if you were missing out on points, I'll get them awarded to you. The one exception for late work is the discussion threads. So I've kind of gotten into the groove of, I want everybody to check into my class every day to incentivize good behavior. And to you guys doing that, I don't know if you've noticed or not, but like one day a week, and there's no like set day that I do this, one, maybe 2 days a week, I'll do one of those discussion threads that's due by midnight. Those I don't take late. Those end up being 25% of your grade. So, you know, if you missed out on points on that quarter one, well, what you got to worry about is your semester grades. That's what factors in your GPA. And at Michigan Center, all classes in the high school break their grades down. This is school board policy. Quarter one is 40%, quarter two is 40%, and your exam is 20%. So even if your quarter one grade is lower than you want it to be, that's not the final grade you get. You have a chance to redeem yourself in quarter two. And if you're watching all my lectures and stuff and taking some good notes, you should ace my exam. So, you know, it's not too late. Even if you put yourself in a hole quarter one, do the best you can to get your percentage up as high as you can, and then you can save it in quarter two and finish with a good semester grade. But again, discussion threads, I throw those in randomly. I'll keep doing that through quarter two. So you should be, they're pretty easy. If you watch my video and just put a little effort in, you'll get your points on that. But you never know which day it's coming. So check in daily and get those done. All right, next up, this is a change of plans. Several times throughout the quarter, I had mentioned you have to keep your notes up until the quarter one exam, and then you can throw everything away. Well, I've put a lot of time and thought and just consideration into this. And I've decided that I'm going to go back to the old way I used to do things and how most classes in the high school operate, which is you have one exam at the end of the semester. Why did I do that? A lot of reasons. I don't want to get into them all here, but we aren't as far as we should be, but I plan to pick up the pace in quarter two. Just a lot of odds and ends kind of from my angle, vantage point of being a teacher, why I decided to do that. The only way that this affects you is instead of taking two medium-sized tests, you'll take one bigger test, but it's really gonna cover the same material. The main thing you need to know is where earlier in the year I had said you could throw your notes away after you take the quarter one exam. Well, there is no quarter one exam. It's gonna be a semester one exam that happens 10 weeks down the road. So keep your notes. Old assignments or anything like that, you don't really need to keep any of that stuff once you've gotten credit for it. But if you're one of the kids that's taking notes, and I know some of you have not been, I'd say if you're a kid that's taking notes, just hold on to them. Keep them in your binder. Those will come in handy. I promise you, those notes, I try to reward people for doing that. And basically all my exam questions come directly from the notes and the things I tell you to write down. And if you're not taking notes, well, guess what? This gives you a reprieve a little bit. Now you're not having an exam come up the end of this week. You can go back and watch my old postings and take notes from them. And for goodness sake, start taking notes now for everything, all the lecture videos I post in a quarter two. All right, so exam, going to a semester instead of a quarter. All right, last thing, and this was kind of, honestly, the main thing I wanted to talk to you about in this video, history journals are due. Like the discussion threads are 25% of your grade. Journals are also 25% of your grade. The other 50%, and I'm talking about your quarterly grade here that you'll get on the report card, the other 50% is all your classwork, the quizzes and assignments, all that stuff that you would have turned in and submitted. So for journals, these are designed to be really easy points. Like, I want to boost everybody's grade with this. I'm trying to throw you guys a bone, and I've always done history journals and made them a pretty big assignment. I've made them worth more this year than I ever have in my whole 15 years of teaching. Why did I do that? Well, I thought this was going to be kind of a weird, start to the school year, which it was. And I wanted to just put a lot of weight for one, this is a kind of a responsibility assignment where you're supposed to keep a tally going over an extended period of time, over 9 weeks. So I'm encouraging that responsibility piece. Also, think about it. I've done 10 journals now. I will have 10 that you'll submit total. They're all in Google Classroom where you can go back and check those old ones. But there also isn't a due date on those until the end of the marking period. So for some of you that don't check in every day, this is a way I'm not slamming you and hammering you every time you might miss a due date or not check in a day. That being said, check in every day if you're not. You should start doing that. That's a good habit to be in. So we're going to have 10 journal entries total. All right. Have all 10 of them done. Go back and reference Google Classroom if you've missed any, or if you can't find any, hit me up and I'll get you the questions so that you can make them up this week. If you submit them incorrectly, so say for example, I'm waiting for somebody to do this. Somebody is going to submit them and have a different Google Doc for every journal. They're going to submit me 10 Google Docs. I'm not going to grade it. I'm sending it back to you. You need to follow instructions. This is pretty simple. You just have one Google Doc that you keep all quarter that you keep reopening and adding to. You should have your name can be the title, your name plus history journals, and then you'll just tally them right off. Journal one, journal two, journal three, and so on up to 10. So I wanna see them all there in one Google Doc so it's easy for me to grade. Again, 25% of your overall grade. So think about this, if maybe you're at a 55% right now you're not looking good. I got a lot of people in that kind of high E range. If you turn these in and get them and they're all done correct, 100%, it's going to bring you up to a passing grade. Looking at it from the other end, though, say you're an A right now. You have a 95%. And you've done pretty good. You've been chiming in on the discussion threads. You got all your assignments in, but you haven't done one journal all quarter. Well, guess what? It's going to drop you like basically 25% there. You're going to drop into like a low C range from an A if you don't do it. So moral of the story is you still got a little time left. If you haven't been getting them done, go make them up, get those finished and submitted to me no later than Friday. If you have been doing them, pat yourself on the back. You don't have to freak out and stress and have anxiety here in the last week of the semester. You just get them all around and make sure they're submitted no later than Friday. Reminder that each one of those for full credit for each journal entry, 1, 2, 3, they have to be 4 lines of writing minimum. Now, most all of my journals, it's not a test or a quiz. I don't read them that close looking for a right or wrong answer or anything like that. When I read through the journals, I skim them pretty quick. There's a few that I pay closer attention to, like journal 10, you're evaluating me and giving me feedback. I promise you, journal 10, I'll read very close for everybody that submits it. But most of them, when we're just talking about Teddy Roosevelt or some history stuff, I will look at it real quick, but they're opinion-based. So it's like, I'm just looking that you put in a little effort. For these, it should be like, well thought out, complete sentences. All right. I want you to, you know, take a good crack at that and put some thought and energy into it. Now, when you're doing your notes, those probably shouldn't be complete sentences. You just want your notes to make sense to you and have quick reference lines. For journals, I want a little bit more. So complete, thoughtful sentences where I can tell that you've watched my lectures and been paying attention. And you're giving me a little effort back, giving me some feedback and kind of telling me what you've learned. Know that, so this video is coming out on Tuesday, all right? I'm going to put them in as a due date for Friday. However, I usually don't do this until after the due date, but this time I am going to put in zeros tomorrow morning. Why am I doing that? Well, in the past, some years, I haven't entered it till after the Friday due date, and there's no column on PowerSchool, and there's no posting, you know, it wasn't Google Classroom last year, but kids kind of get caught off guard by it. And then by the time they realize they didn't turn that in and they see their grade drop, it's too late to do anything. So I feel like I'm trying to do you a favor by putting zeros in Wednesday for anybody that hasn't submitted them up to that point, even though it's before the deadline. So if you don't have them in by then, you'll see where your grade's gonna be, your kind of finalized grade, if you don't turn in the journals. As soon as you turn them in though, up to this Friday, I will, as quick as I can, add your points in and you'll see your grade rebound and hopefully boost up if you did them all correctly and put some effort into it. So zeros and grades will go in Wednesday, even though it's before the due date deadline. But the deadline is Friday, 10/23, the last day of the quarter. So by midnight Friday, you need to get them into me to get your full credit on them. And honestly, this is one of the only assignments I can't accept late because report cards are getting printed. I don't know when Ms. Blakeman does it, but it's like first thing Monday morning. So if you turn it into me next week on Tuesday, sorry, it's too late. Report cards are already run. You have to get these in by the deadline. And I don't feel too bad about that because, I mean, we have been doing this all quarter and I've given multiple reminders on this. So if you haven't caught this till now, well, shame on you. You need to check in more. Anyway, hopefully everybody's got them wrapped up. So can't get them in late, get those done. If you have questions about anything grading related, journals, discussion threads, assignments, late work, for goodness sakes, hit me up. I'll probably be pretty busy this week, but I'm usually pretty good at email turnaround. I definitely will hit you up within a day of you sending me an email, and I'll try my best to get back to you much sooner than that. So have a good one. Be productive this week. Go check in on all your classes. Be proactive. Get those grades up. And then pretty soon we'll be back to kind of normal routine as we're rolling into quarter 2. See ya.